Hello, everybody. Hi there, Aginor S. How's it going? Felagon, how you doing? Thank you for joining me today. Oh, Felagon, I've got something to show you. I'll show it to you right now, in fact. Let me load up Landmark here. This is episode 2 of Castles and Crapshacks. This particular episode, we are going to be covering... new biomes, pretty much. I don't have a specific destination, but... Oops. There we go. There's the title slide for this episode. Code of Voss, hello, how are you doing? So, just getting into game here. Let me know if the game music is a little bit too loud or not. Alright. So. We're going to be showing off some of the new biomes. We've got some really lovely stuff going on. And there's been some really awesome builds already. Just in the short amount of time. So this is actually what I've been working on. It's basically continuing my floating architecture. It's all polished stone right now. That'll probably change at some point, but it's just a pretty good starting material to use here. And if I can manage to get up there... Whoops. I've actually got something kind of cool on top to show everybody. I guess that's the butt right there. So, I can latch onto that. Maybe right here. There we go. Oh, whoops, I get it. The slide is in the way. My apologies, everybody. So, here, I will start from the top down. So, we have a pentapod. We also have this, this hilarious tree here. Now, funny story about this tree. I put it up here, the very tippy top of my claim attached to a claim, and then I scaled it up way, way, way big. And I think the origin point of the model actually got scaled outside of my claim because now I can't delete it or manipulate it or anything. So unfortunately, I have this awesome huge tree coming off the side of my claim that I totally don't want and can't do anything with. So Felagon, if you're willing to mess around with this one, oh yeah, when you get far enough, you just kind of drop off because it disappears. this is Courage Kettle, right by the hub. As you can see, the hub is like right down here. I'd really love to get that tree removed. I put in a bug report, and I don't know if that's the sort of thing that actually gets action or if it just gets things noted. But anyway, I'm going to kind of go way out to the outer reaches here. Where's my running stuff? I'm going to switch out to my boots so I can get through here a lot quicker. I'm going to go way out to the corner and just start showing it off. No, it's not able to be chopped down. It says I cannot harvest that. I got tons of stone. I've got 500,000 stone right now because I wanted to make some stuff. So, let me switch out here. All right, and now that I run blazing fast, I'll start the trek to the far corner where I shall begin the tour. So, I really hope we can get up to 1,000 followers today so I can give away that trailblazer. There have been some weird things going on. Twitch has been enforcing terms of service and apparently took action against a notable user, though their account has been restored since then, due to giveaways. Now, I believe it's because Twitch is a US-based company, or that US-based players or products can only be, you know, handled in the United States. So it's kind of weird like that. There's ways to get around it that exists so it doesn't get considered as gambling. So if we actually do get up to that point, then I'll probably end up having to do that. Also, there's a decent chance that we'll get a little visit from potentially Omid Daryani or Dave Georgeson or, you know, plenty of other folks. We already have Felgon here. He's also on the team and very active in joining the various live streams. So everybody say hello. Yeah, Agenor. Eventually, I probably will just go with that. I haven't had a chance to sit down and talk with him about the specifics and getting it all set up yet, but that's definitely on the schedule for this week, is to figure that out. I've got something I can do in the interim that will be just fine, but where the heck am I going that way? Man, this lag. Oh, and you can also find him on Twitter, I believe. It's at FelgonSOE, if I'm not mistaken. Traveling too fast. The game just can't keep up. Kadzu, hello, how are you doing? Comrist, I don't remember if I said hello to you or not. Hello. I'm digging this biome. It just takes a little while for everything to dry in. That's fine. For some reason, I don't expect us to really be moving this fast all the time if we're trying to harvest things. Ah, I keep getting turned around. That lag. What are you talking about? I said hello before your first message went off the chat log. That counts. It's not like I scrolled up and it's like towards the very top. It's like, oh, hello. I didn't even notice. So it's been recommended for me to have some music going in the background. Is that something you folks would actually like, or should I just keep with the game sounds and the talking so it doesn't get too muddy with the audio? Yeah, I'm really excited to see some of the co-op builds people are going to be doing. I'm sure there's going to be some really amazing stuff people are going to do. I've already seen some amazing stuff people have done with the expanded claims. Alright, so it looks like the tour begins with a dirt farm with some equipment on it. I could be wrong, but I don't think I'm gonna stick around to find out. Also, I don't know why that giant thing was flashing across the screen, but that happens from time to time. It's like some weird vertices get stretched over a large area or something. So here's a double claim. Now let's see what they've actually done with it here. I get you, Calm. So they've got this nice checkerboard with all of their tools on it. They've got the next claim over attached. That's really disappointing. I'm gonna head south. Maybe that one with a 3 on it's got something nice going. Yeah, you know, that's something I actually brought up both on Into the Portal and on Light Feature Rant, is lag is going to be a huge issue if we've got to be running away from masses of mobs like this, or if we could potentially be running into a giant mass of mobs and we don't know until they all draw and land upon us. Okay, so what I did, Felga, what I did, I created a claim, I put the claim attachment on it, I put a second claim attachment on it, not realizing it just overlapped where the first claim attachment was. No big deal. So I eventually had removed that one, but before I removed it, I had built that giant tree up there, you see. So I put the tree up there, I pushed it all the way up as far as it would allow me, and then I scaled it out as far as I possibly could, all the way out, so it would make this giant land bridge sort of thing. And at that point, when I deselected it, that was the last time I could interact with it. It was pretty much stuck in position. So I was thinking, well, what the hell, maybe if I try to delete that third claim, maybe that'll get rid of it somehow, and it'll just clear all of that stuff out. It didn't, and it's still not accessible. I haven't tried clearing the upper half of the claim out, and I can give that a try if you'd like, but actually, Felgon, I don't know if this is something that I should be announcing or not, but I'm going to be putting in my application for QA this week for SOE. So, I'll still be breaking the game, but I'll be doing it a little closer to home so you can shoot me with Nerf darts when I do it, I guess. Man. So this is a crap shack here, but at least it's, you know, kind of a pretty little crap shack. I mean, they've got their tools and stuff laid out. It's as if, you know, they've got plans for the rest of the infrastructure and they just, you know, got lazy. Maybe there's something else up here and I'm just missing an entrance, but I'm not so sure about that. Yeah, Falgon, actually, I could have taken the position a year ago, but I just didn't have the assets to be able to do it comfortably. Now that I do, it's definitely something that I can pursue. I understand the wages they're offering for QA might not be optimal, but there's a lot of overtime, so yeah. It should be interesting, but hopefully I won't have to worry about that stuff too much if I'm mostly over at the office working on the game. Diamond Beard. Not as much overtime. Well, that's fine. I mean, less overtime means that I get to keep on doing the live stream schedule and keep broadcasting on the weekends and in the evenings when I'm done. Awesome. The amazing powers of admin. Thank you very, very much. I really appreciate it. That thing was quite a nuisance. That I don't even. So while there isn't very much to show with these claims, apparently, I hope that people would be building up a bit more. Look at the trees, it's just lovely. So, some of them have some faces on them. Like that, it's got that kind of nose and a couple of eyes sticking out, or poking in rather. There's another face, kind of beardy, mustachey looking thing. That's really cool. That was done really well. Toronto Tiggs, hello. How are you doing? So far, it's been a whole lot of misses. My own claim has been the only thing I've seen so far that's really been worthwhile. But I know that there's awesome claims here on this island. I know it. I've seen them. But after I'm done on this island, there's a good chance I'm going to figure out, I'm going to have to find out where some of the more prominent builders have gone and brought their communities, because this is kind of void-like here. Hey! Fancy, fancy! So, they've got some tools and a couple lights set up. Some sort of path in the works here. Cool. Some grassy, some astroturf so they can hit some golf balls off in the distance. That's kind of what this makes me think of here, that this whole thing is just astroturf and they just kind of set up right here with a long iron or something and fling rocks out in the distance. Uh, I like these lights. They don't seem to turn on, though. Oh, well. So seeing the snowy trees here along with the, this kind of grassy area, that's neat. That's kind of a cool effect. See if they've done anything else with their claim here. Nope. Somebody else. Alright. Continuing along. I'm going to swing back up north here and check that triple up there. Asphyx, hello. How are you doing? Asphyx 33. Alright, so they've got giant trees blocking some of the pathways around. Cool. Yeah. Let's just do that. Oh. Pips. Just a pile of micro voxels. That's funny. So what are they actually doing up here then? Thanks, Asphyx. Huh. What's up with this grassy stuff? Is that a new material or is that a prop or something? Does anybody know? It's pretty cool. I guess it's a prop. It looks pretty uniform. Obelisk. It looks like some sort of arena shooter map or something. Like I would, like I'd imagine some old school Doom weapons getting used in a place like this, or maybe Quake would be more like it. I guess it wouldn't be Doom because you have platforms underneath platforms in the. The thing with Doom is that everything, it was just a flat plane, more or less. Interesting. Some booze. And there's their wall of pips again. Aginor, I've already begun it, and I will show it off during my tour here, what I've gotten going. Let's see, I'm going to go there and then loop back down. Yeah, that'll do. I'm about 90% sure this is a Crapshack. Yeah, those vine props are really cool. Can probably do a lot with those. So, it's pretty much just a Crapshack. They've done a couple of things. They've messed around. They made a micro voxel ladder. That's kind of cute. Better island this weekend. Maybe not better, but probably going to be a lot shorter to get through. Hi, Lock 7 times. How are you doing? I'm just gonna circle back this way then. Crapshack. Maybe for the next episode, I'll actually have a screenshot of the map up, and I'll stamp in my castle or crap shack as I go along. Because this appears to be a crap shack. No, I take it back. A crap shack would be a compliment for that dirt farm on a peak. I'm just gonna steal the prime territory. I'm not gonna do anything with it. Alright, I'm gonna circle back down this way then. I'm doing just fine. I've got some Eggs Benedict on the way. Not immediately, but at the 2 hour mark, I'm probably going to take a break for a few minutes to grub down on that. It's not just any Eggs Benedict, it's being made by, let's say he's a grandmaster chef in training, because he's already pretty damn good. Nice. Oh, and it finally detailed in. There we go. Fancy. Fancy schmancy. Whoops. Not much to it, but you know what? I really like it. It's I could see something like this going up on Player Studio and doing really, really well. Just very small, very simple. Fire up the grill. Is it a new grill or is it just the first time you fired it up? Hey, Felgon, do you know if we are actually supposed to be able to stack our claims 3 high or not? Or if it's just too high for the moment, we'd have to put the third one below. Because I'd really like to be able to put a second attachment on top of my current one. But it doesn't seem to want to let me do that. First time this year. Been too cold, huh? Where do you live, or what region do you live in, if you don't want to give the specific details? It's a nice little, it's a little start. It's got something to it. It's not a crap shack. They actually put a little bit of effort into it. That's all I ask at this point. It's alpha. Just put in a little bit of effort. It's not like the game's gone live, you know. Man, there's gonna be tearing down crap shacks everywhere when the game goes live. You better believe it. Of course, I'm also gonna have to have some serious equipment to be able to go across the island at a quick enough pace. I don't see a claim here. Does anybody see a claim here? No. No claim. Illinois, yeah. Oh, yeah. I imagine it's cold out there right now. Or had been pretty cold. Yeah, I've tried that, Felgon Com. I've tried that. It didn't work for me. When I get back to my claim, I'll try it again, and we'll see if we can get it to work. Maybe I'd just been on long enough, or I'd done certain things that prevented that feature from actually working properly. But I wasn't able to do that. Maybe it was that damn tree. Okay, so this person's gotten started with something, but maybe they ran out of materials or had to leave or something. I don't know. Probably ran out of materials. Oh, and I see the doors rotated again. They're all off axis again. I don't know why they keep doing it, but like every other update, they get kicked out of position. I'm guessing it's just something the devs are doing to mess with us and see how long it's been since someone's actually been at a claim. A melting type castle. Yeah, I might actually do that with mine eventually, is change it from stone to ice and then just have icicles and like melty kind of stuff coming off of it. I don't see a claim here. Does anybody see a claim here? I think it's a dirt farm. Nice spot, buddy. For anybody just joining us, this is EverQuest Next Landmark, Castles and Crapshacks, Episode 2, showing off the new biomes and the neat little things people have built in it. And a few grand things, but we'll see those a little later on. Kinsacks, huh? They're building. Words of encouragement. I hope they turn it into a castle, not a crap shack. Oh, something really cool. If you paint polished granite on a natural mountain, it looks really cool, especially when the sun shines across it. Here's a castle. Hey. Mortar cane. I've seen them before. I am on Courage Kettle, lock 7 times. Alright, see you later, Asphyx. Take it easy. And have fun building. If you need stone or ice or anything like that, hit me up. I've got an abundance right now. Got the equipment here in a nice place. Kind of the some supports, arches. Yes, yes, nice, 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 nice. Yes, yes, yes. It's a good placement for that torch. Like the sense of design here. Got a spiral staircase. Little hangout area. Going up. That's pretty cool. That's really well done. Probably one of the best ones we're going to see today. What kind of rock is what? Which rock? Hmm. Cancel wall. Yeah, this wall would be a lot more defensible if they could put artificial boundaries up through the hills, like a an MMO that likes to gate their content. But you know what? I really like the look of this wall. It's pretty snazzy. This is really nice use. And they did the thing with the separated arches that was shown on the demonstration video. So that's really cool. Very well done. It looks like it'll stop a lot. I hope an iron golem doesn't just punch right through it. It'd be like the Kool-Aid Man. Oh yeah. Diggs, how's it going? How are you enjoying that ice? For anybody who doesn't know, Diggs won a 250,000 ice on Into the Portal. Just on Friday, actually. Wonder if there's anything in these or if they're grappler death traps. Grappler death trap! Very nice. None shall pass. That's funny. That's a really good claim. I'm glad we got a chance to see it. Alright, see you later, Asphyx33. Have a good one. Not sure if you can use it all before the end of the month. Are you kidding me? I've already used 1,000,000 stone, and that was just since Thursday. Yeah, there's nothing here. I guess the orange made it look like there was something there, but no, there's nothing. Hopefully they'll do something with that dirt farm. Yeah, Calm. Where it'll be 12 claims just to have the surrounding wall. So Felton, how have things been going with the two attached claims so far? Has been running pretty stable and everything's been pretty solid, or is there still some wobbliness that needs to be tested? Because I remember they were saying, you know, they can just increase it to you know, as many claims as they want, the dev team over there, but they wanted to test out two first. So, how's two been working? Just curious. You don't have to answer that if it's a little too specific. I see they've got some more going on here. It's just not not finished yet. Still need to evaluate the data and stuff. Cool. Cool, cool. Well, it's definitely been a lot of fun having more claims, and I've seen a lot of amazing stuff already. We got an Onod. This one's kind of out in the middle of nowhere. I'll get this before I loop back towards the other ones. Nothing to see here, folks. Move along. There's nothing to see here, citizen. Move along. A giant igloo, huh? That's pretty cool. I don't think there's anything here, but I'll give it the courtesy of checking anyway. Wait, I was just here, wasn't I? No, this is someone else's. I like the start. It appears they have quite lofty intentions, but just haven't gotten around to it. I mean, I guess by I like the start, I mean it looks like they actually have a plan to use that space, and I hope they do something with it. Yeah, Diggs, if you want to make a snowman that's truly gigantic, you're probably going to need to build a voxel sphere of just the smallest, the one by ones, and then you know, smooth very carefully until you get it to how you need it. How do you folks like the new smooth tool? I've heard a lot of people like it, and I've heard a lot of people really hate it. So what's the consensus, everybody? Going on here. Yeah. Only not like you need to build up your claims, sucker. Let's see. Sweep across. So I think I'm just going to keep going this way for now. That's cool. Home of future something. Well, that's ambitious, but for right now, it's a dirt farm with a couple little rocks floating here and there. I wouldn't quite count it as a claim, or as a anything more than a dirt farm, rather. Not even a crap shack. Diggs, that's a great idea. That'll probably be the one I go to after this one, then. After this island is done. It's a crap shack. People just taking these really nice spots and then doing nothing with them. It's just a dirt farm with some heavy equipment on it. For shame. For shame. Disappointing. Have I checked this one yet? I don't think so. Falcon or sure. Well, it's a treehouse. It's nice. That's cool, Felgon. Do you have any idea what you're gonna build, or are you just gonna mess around for a little bit and experiment for a while? So they still have some work to do here, but at least they've got a start. It's better than some of what we've seen. Yeah, I'll go across to this one. Yeah, those live streams are just, they're really good. Landmark Live has been a pretty great show. The scale town. It looked really nice, but then the other thing I looked at is like, well, it's cool, but it's not functional. Like, it's, you know, you can use it for decoration, to make like a diorama, but you really can't, you know, have people walking around too much in those buildings. They're not really going to have that much space if they're that scale. So apparently this person wants to do something, but they've just kind of dug out of a mountain. It's kind of a crap shack. It's not anything to it. Moving on. Oh, I know what you mean. Not the scale New York or whatever. You're talking about the little actual city town thing. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's really cool. I'm looking forward to that. I hope it goes really well. Let's see, what have they drawn here? I can't. Still detailing. Oh, there we go. Okay. It's Mario and Frog Mario. I think that's supposed to be the princess or something. Koopa Troopa. Maybe when the lights are on or something. Harley Quinn. That's funny. The Moonanites. Some more Mario. Samus, Mega Man, shooting a Pokeball, that's hilarious. SpongeBob, that's a fucked up looking SpongeBob. And it looks like some sort of a cross between Blanca and Goku. Does anybody know? Is that from like Naruto or something? I don't know who the one on the right is. Yes, Ignignok and Urd, that's right. Those are the Moonanites, Felgon. Oh, I didn't see that up there. Is that Ninja Gaiden? I think. What? That's Sonic? Okay. So there's more up here. Maybe not there. Up in here. There we go. Oh, that's really cool. Like a 3D chessboard. That's fun. Oh yeah, and that's a funny bug. Light indigo pick, heavy copper axe. Sometimes, I guess it's not doing it right now, sometimes it'll do heavy add tool, heavy delete tool, heavy line tool, and I don't know why, but it's kind of funny. I guess the chat channels are working. So I've got another source of chat going, so the chat isn't going to be so stagnant. Alright. With a signpost? I don't think there's a claim here. Oh. And it's a Crapshack. Crapshack. Well, it looks like they're starting something here. That's kind of cool, I guess. I hope they continue it. It's just kind of a crap shack right now. The POW. No, you've got some effort into it. Your tower's pretty neat. I definitely do want to see the finished product when it's done, though. think there's a Nidhogg tournament going on right now. Fun game. I don't know if anybody's familiar. Oh, nice. It's all way down here. They even dug it down to make it deeper. That's cool. I think it's still loading. For anybody who's wondering, I have a little bit of history with RPX Nepal there. We're both Raging Primates, and we've been since Planet Side 1. I joined back in, I think it was January of 2004, and been a member ever since. Planet Side 1, Planet Side 2, there was a contingent on WoW for a bit. And, you know, probably some other games. I like how they got the, once again, the separated arches go on there to, you know, keep it nice and tidy. I wonder if you need to do that anymore, if the new smoothing tool allows you to get the arches close together without getting nasty, or to clean up that nastiness that can occur. It's kind of nice. I do like this place. I saw the inside of my character's head for a split second. Just long enough to see the teeth. So what else is there in this place? Nice, a lot of arches. I do like the pink and the green everywhere, the amaranthine and that kind of mossy grassy stuff being placed everywhere. It definitely gives it a really rich kind of look to it. I think there's some striped wood or something they're also using bits of here and there. Really colorful. Murek. Nicely done. I like it. Looks like there's still some work to be done on it, but even in its current state, it's pretty sweet. So I think I'm going to be cutting back across now. Yeah. I don't know if we're going to actually reach 1,000 viewers today, so I don't mean to say temper your expectations, but I don't know if that Trailblazer is going to be given away on this show today here. You know, could get bombed by a bunch of people and 1,000 people randomly show up. But, you know, it's fine if it doesn't. It's just a fun show to do and look at cool builds and get some neat ideas from it. So they've got something started here. Definitely a lot of work to go before it's clear of a Crapshack status, though, but you know, it's at least a nice start. It's, you know, a staircase more than some of what we've seen. I saw Murek with that awesome thing of ruins down there. It still needs some work. It's got the makings of something that isn't a crap shack. And that's the nice thing. But right now it's a crap shack. Across that way. Did I check this one up here? I'll double check just to be sure it's not that far away. No, not much here. Oh, actually. It's kind of nice. Definitely the start of something nice. Hope they continue it. They're probably fixing too. So is everybody all building in game right now? I'm watching this in a second monitor. Or on their phone. Yeah, I get it, buddy. Put a giant tree in the middle if you're Clay. I understand. What was that? Is Dave Georgeson live streaming? No Mead? Or is that person just teasing us right now? Oh, really? Nice. Very cool. Well, if that's the case, I can understand why there isn't anybody here. Struggling with the roof, huh? What kind of roof are you making? Like a, some sort of angled roof, or is it going to be smooth and curved? I can see that's just a crap shack in the distance. I don't even need to visit it. So here's another wall. I think it's bigger than the other one, but not nearly as impressive. Didn't use the line tool, you wanted more of that ribbed effect. I gotcha. Yeah, if you're just doing the, up and at angles or whatever, I could see that. Yeah, this is a massive crap shack. This is a monumental amount of plaster? Snow? I'm not sure which one. But they're using a hell of a lot of it, not doing very much. It'll be nice when they get some detail up in it, though. I'm sure it'll be lovely. And because it's right by my claim, I'll be able to check up on it frequently. So, yeah, I'll probably send out some pictures when it's actually nice. Nice little house. Kind of needs a roof. It's a little drafty right now. Oh, that's cool, Toronto. So that's really all there is to this place. Is the door broken? No, the door is working properly. Assuming they wanted to open inside and not out.